let n be a natural number. If n squared is even, then n is even. This is the statement that we're going to prove. But we're going to give an indirect proof of this. So we're going to prove the contrapositive statement, which is as follows. If n is odd, then n squared is odd. First, notice that every odd integer can be written as 2k plus 1 for some integer k. For example, if you look at the integer minus 5, it can be written as 2 times minus 3 plus 1. So if n is odd, there is an integer k such that n is equal to 2k plus 1. Therefore, n squared is simply 2k plus 1 squared. And expanding this, we get 4k squared plus 4k plus 1. And if we factor out 2 from these first two terms, I get 2 times 2 times k squared plus 2k and then plus 1. But now, this here, 2k squared plus 2k, is an integer. So I have written n squared as 2 times some integer plus 1. And so I can say that n squared is odd. And that completes the proof. So we have proved that if n is odd, then n squared is odd. But since this is the contrapositive of the original statement, we have proved the original statement. And this is an example of an indirect proof. Now, indirect proofs often manifest themselves as proofs by contradiction. Instead of stating explicitly the contrapositive and proving that, one starts by assuming the negation of the conclusion and obtain a statement that is absurd or contradicts the original assumptions. For example, to prove this statement up here, what you would do is you would first assume the conclusion is false. In other words, suppose that n is not even, and try to obtain a contradiction. And this is essentially what we have done here. We are assuming that n is odd, and obtain that n squared is odd. And n squared is odd is a contradiction to the assumption that n squared is even in the original statement.